So, good morning from Australia. So, I'm now in Sydney, and this is here the southern part. And I arrived yesterday evening in the night here, and this is now morning. And yeah, what you can see here, this is on my balcony here, the southern part, there is the harbor. This is the Botany Bay, the really famous Botany Bay, where Cook first landed with Banks and Solander, these two British botanists, and it's called Botany Bay because they found here so much variety of different new species, so they called it Botany Bay. And by the way, they suggested to establish there the city, not where the city is now. Some hundred years later, there is now the shift to the Botany Bay to build the harbor there. So there's the harbor, and there's also the airport. And you will hear it perhaps somewhere that some planes will fly over us here. And you can see nice surrounding here. And there's a university, and there are some old buildings there. And it's currently spring, and no, not really spring, so it's getting warm. Today I think 25 degrees, but in the night, this night I think was 13 degrees. And what I've seen also, now perhaps I haven't seen it correct, this is the jacaranda tree there, the tree without leaves. So if you see any trees without leaves, the chance is high that this is jacaranda, and they are flowering really nice purple in the next weeks. And perhaps I have seen already some purple flowers, but this is currently not the season. So in the next 3 weeks I expect that this will be more purple. And let's switch over here now. In this direction there, this is Cronulla, Botany Bay, Cronulla. And if you go here over, you can't see it in the distance. I can see it really, really, and yeah, not so good at the end. That there is the Blue Mountains. And if you look here to the right side, this is the CBD, the Central Business District of Sydney. And it looks a little bit far away, but it's not far away. So I normally walk there, and this is only 10-15 minutes to walk there to the subway, and then it's I think 2 or 3 stations to the CBD, and this is 10-12 minutes with the subway, not really far away. And yeah, that's it more or less. And this is here, this suburb is called Zetland. This is named after Shetland, because they said it looked here like in the Shetlands. And this was all here swampy wetland area, and you can see it somewhere in some places there. For example, there was an old mill, water mill, and if you drive with the bike, I did it very often here around there, around the airport, around the Botany Bay, and there's all swamps, wetland, and this is not very high here. And yeah, I will give you a tour around the room here, and let's see how it looks. So this is how it looks from inside. This is really a nice apartment. This is here at the corner in the 21st floor. And yeah, you have everything what you need. Where should we start now? So this is the living room. There is a sleeping room, a bathroom, and there's also a kitchen. And let's start first with the TV. We have a nice TV here. And yeah, many channels. I don't use it really. And we have here a storage thing, you can store your things, and there is a table for eating. An absolutely nice view here. If you open everything, here's the M1, and there in south direction the Botany Bay. And I said before, I was there on the balcony, on the terrace, and let's go further. There is a desk that you can do some work here. There's a telephone. What else do we have? Then we have here the small kitchen. There is a microwave. And what else do we have here? Yeah, here inside is a toaster. This is only a small, how is it called? I forgot it. You see it. And we are really full equipped with everything what you need. Some glasses. Then what else do we have here? Here some pots then for pasta, some things. Then we have here more things. Here we have something more. Everything, kitchen, utilities. Then we have here, very important, dishwasher. Then we have here a coffee machine. And this is supplied daily, if you want, so that you have always coffee and tea, sugar. Then you have a kettle here. What else do we have? We have a huge fridge, nothing inside. Here is something inside, and you get also milk daily if you want. And again, this nice view, you can go outside from this way and you can sit here. And currently this is 22 degrees, so this is absolutely fantastic. Always the view here to the right side. Oh, this is spider web. Well, don't care about this. And then the Botany Bay, the Blue Mountains to the west. Yeah, it's absolutely nice to sit here. Let's go here in this direction. What else do we have? There's an AC here for the main room. And then we have here the storage room, I already told. And then let's go first to the sleeping room. You have a second TV here. And also a second AC. And yeah, again, it's a nice view from around here. And there's also something to lock your valuables. Something more to store your belongings. Then this here, this is very important. This is a washing machine and the dryer. And this is already done here. This is nice, I have to dry it. This is absolutely perfect if you have this. This was also why I chose this room here, this suite, because if you're here for a longer time, then you need to wash your clothes, and this is absolutely important. Here's nothing really inside. And yeah, I don't know what to do with this here. And you get even supplied with some washing liquid here. But I brought my own because I'm too lazy to ask all the time here at the reception if it's empty, so I keep my door locked for some days and it's not every day cleaned. And so I supply by myself. And then let's go. This is the bathroom. The bathroom. Let's go inside here. How it looks. Yeah. So this is the best room. And yeah, it's not really big. You have a shower there. You have a bathtub. This is really nice. And you also have something, some supplies here, like shower gel or yeah, soap and such things, paper towels. And this comes everything with the room, and then there's some huge storage possibilities here.
behind these mirrors. And that's it, more or less. That's not much more here. This is a relatively small room, but it's okay, it's nice. There are bigger rooms, they look bigger. I'm not sure if they are really bigger. But I like this corner room because you have a much better view. What's not so nice is it's the street there, because this can be really noisy. But here, this is it's still okay. So I was there at the lower floor last time I was here. I think on the other side of the building, on the other corner, and this was much more noise. So this is still okay, and you have a nice view to the Botany Bay, to the Blue Mountains here. And what's great is, this A380, I think it's A380. It's not the A380. Starting here in this direction, and this is nice. You can see also the planes in this direction. This is New Zealand, where he's flying. This is Air New Zealand. You can see this on the colors. They have a really nice design, this black. This is Air New Zealand. So this is, if they are turning around here in this direction, they are flying to Auckland or Christchurch or such things. What did I want to say? The noise level, this is okay. And the sun is rising on here, on the west side. Which side is it again? This is east, on the east side here. And then it's setting perfectly here on the west side in the Blue Mountains. This is always absolutely fantastic, but this is a little bit negative because it's hot. It's absolutely hot in the afternoon. Currently it's spring, it's still okay, but this evening this will be really hot then. Here all the sun shining through the windows, and you can't even sit outside because it's so hot. And what else do we have to say here? Can be expensive. So this is the main entrance here below somewhere, and this building is a part of it. I think this building too, but I never have been there, and this building is also a part of it. And perhaps these are larger suites here. It looks much bigger than you can see. The terrace is huge here, and can be really expensive. I think for today I pay, or someone this week, up to $450. It's really expensive, but it can also go down to 90. And I have to take it, because it's only 1-2 days where it's so expensive, over $400. Because I think there is a race, a game, something like this, where everything is booked out. You can't see the Randwick race course. This is here around the corner. And this is, so I have anyway no chance, because it's all in Sydney really expensive. And I don't want to go there somewhere else. You can see perhaps in a very distance, this could be Blacktown or Parramatta or something like this. And this is too far away for me. So in mean, it's still okay, but it's you can expect perhaps in mean in euro, perhaps 150 euro per night. Is this in mean if you stay here longer? It's cheaper, I think, on Sunday and Monday. It's perhaps the cheapest, but then it can go really up on Friday and Saturday especially. And the planes, sometimes they fly over directly over the hotel. It's sometimes not so nice, but it depends always on the route. So I had the chance to watch every 4 months now this route where the planes are flying. And normally they come there, they land there from this direction, from north, where all the connections from Asia are coming, or there from the Blue Mountains coming from Europe. And then this direction goes here to Auckland, New Zealand, and here in this direction also then back to Asia, in this direction to Europe. But somehow this changes all the time. How they are flying, so you can't avoid that they turn here. For example, this plane perhaps flies to Asia or some. No, this is Qantas, I don't know, somewhere to the north. And to avoid that they are here turning to New Zealand. And there are quite a lot
of planes every day flying to New Zealand. This is, by the way, absolutely cheap. It's only 2 hours this direction, and you are for $400, you are so 400 Australian dollars, this is 300 euro, you are in New Zealand. Two hours, I think, is the flight. Yes, and that's it. It's an absolutely fantastic suite. And the Samaritan Suites, I stayed here in many different... I stayed here also here somewhere below. This was not so nice, was a little bit dark. And always around the corner. And this room here is, I think, my favorite. I would say it's absolutely fantastic. You have everything what you need. There is here, it's not visible if you go in this direction, there is a supermarket, a mall, of course, it's not far away, it's only some minutes. And so you are really connected to everything here. And yeah, what else do I have to say? Yeah. It's absolutely nice neighborhood, and some people said this whole area is perhaps not even 5 years old. And you can also see there is crane, this building is new, I haven't seen this before. So there's a lot of construction work. If you look to the city, there are so many cranes. This there, Green Square, last time I was here it was not ready. Yesterday evening I have seen the lights, and this is also new. Where the cranes are, a huge building, and again this will be also a really high building, and you can see also perhaps in the distance there a complete suburb built new, all the cranes. So there's huge construction work here in Sydney, because in the last 10 years I think it gained, oh there's a plane coming again here, 1 million people here in Sydney, 10 years, so this is every year 100,000 people, and it's crazy. Even this house is here, they are looking really more expensive, but even the crappiest towers you can find here is over 1 million. And if you search, for example, at realestate.com.au, you will not find any house below 1 million Australian dollars, so this is 750,000 euro or dollar. So everything is much higher than 1 million here. This is more perhaps because of the whole property of the space of the area where it's located, and I don't know how long it takes until it's gone here. And this is an interesting neighborhood, by the way, if you walk through. Absolutely different to this higher, newer buildings. But what's really interesting is everything is built here with a huge amount of glass. This is absolutely nice. It seems in summer really hot, but you have all light coming in, like this suite here. And it looks... and the inside is always... some light, so you can see the people living there. It must be really expensive to live here. But okay, that's it. What else do I have to say for Meriton Suites? Nothing really special. There are many different Meriton Suites. So this is Zetland. I think there's somewhere at the airport is one. Then in the city center is one. And also Bondi Junction is one. There's a plane coming again. Bondi Junction we can't see, this is here around at near Bondi Beach. And so there are many different and Parramatta is also one. This is perhaps the cheapest, so you can choose. And this is a really fantastic location, I absolutely can recommend. It's expensive, but the other hotels in Sydney are also expensive. And for what you can get here, if you stay longer, this is much better, especially if you are staying here with more than one person, it's absolutely recommended here. So okay, thanks for watching, and see you then in the next video from somewhere here in Sydney perhaps.